Let us study about lateral wall of nose. Lateral wall of nose is irregular due to the presence of self-like bony projections called concha. This concha, they increases the surface area for effective air conditioning of the inspired air. The lateral wall separates the nose from the orbit above by the intervening ethmoidal air sinus, maxillary air sinus below, and in front from the lacrimal groove and the nasolacrimal canal. The lateral wall of the nose is subdivided into an anterior part, middle part, and a posterior part. Anterior part, it has a small depressed area that is called the vestibule. The vestibule is lined by a modified skin with a short, stiff, curved hairs called vibrissae. The middle part is called the atrium of middle meatus, and the posterior part contains the conchae and meatus. Next is about the skeletal framework of lateral wall. The lateral wall is partly bony, partly cartilaginous, and partly cuticular. The bony part is formed by the following bones from before backwards. They are the nasal bone, frontal process of maxilla, lacrimal bone, inferior nasal concha, which is an independent bone, middle nasal concha, and the superior nasal concha. They are the projections from the medial side, medial surface of the labyrinthine part of ethmoid bone, perpendicular plate of palatine bone, medial pterygoid plate of sphenoid bone. Then the next part is cartilaginous part. The cartilaginous part is formed by superior and inferior nasal cartilage and alar cartilages. Cuticular part is formed by the fibrofatty tissue covered by skin. This is about the formation of the lateral wall. Next is about the conchae and meatus. Conchae are, they are curved bony projections, and they are the inferior nasal concha, middle nasal concha, and superior nasal concha. The space beneath each conchae are called the meatus. Now, this inferior nasal concha, it is an independent bone. Superior and middle nasal concha, they are the projections from the medial surface of the labyrinthine part of ethmoid bone. Next, we are going to study about meatus in detail. Meatus, or the space beneath each concha, are called the meatus. They are inferior meatus, middle meatus, and superior meatus. Now we are going to study in detail about the individual meatus. First, we will take the inferior meatus. Inferior meatus is the space beneath the inferior nasal concha. The inferior meatus receives the opening of the nasolacrimal duct at the junction between anterior 1/3 and the posterior 2/3. The opening of the nasolacrimal duct is guarded by the lacrimal fold or the Huffner's valve. Next, about the middle meatus. Middle meatus is the space beneath the middle nasal concha. The features over the middle meatus are, the first one is a rounded elevation, which is called the ethmoidal bulle. This ethmoidal bulle is formed by the underlying middle ethmoidal air sinus. Now, this middle ethmoidal air sinus, they open into the upper margin of this bulle. The next one is, below to this ethmoidal bulle, there is a deep semicircular sulcus, which is called as an hiatus semilunaris. The anterior end of the hiatus semilunaris, it leads into an funnel-shaped channel that is called infundibulum. Through the infundibulum, the frontal air sinus, which opens into the anterior end of the hiatus semilunaris. The margin of this infundibulum receives the opening of anterior ethmoidal air sinus. At its posterior end, the posterior end of the hiatus semilunaris, near its floor, it receives the opening of the maxillary air sinus. So, the openings of the middle meatus are, one is middle ethmoidal air sinus, frontal air sinus, anterior ethmoidal air sinus, and the maxillary air sinus. So see here again, this is the hiatus semilunaris that is receiving all the air sinus opening. The next is about the superior meatus. Now the superior meatus is a space beneath the superior nasal concha. The superior meatus receives the opening of the posterior ethmoidal air sinus. above to the superior nasal concha, there is a triangular depressed area which is called as a sphenoethmoidal rhesus. Now this sphenoethmoidal rhesus receives the opening of the sphenoidal air sinus. Now the next one is structures that are related to the middle meatus. In front of the middle meatus, there is a depressed area which is called the atrium of the middle meatus, just above to the vestibule. And this atrium of the middle meatus is limited above by a faint ridge which is called as an agernase. This is about the conchas and meatus and the air sinus which are opening into the meatus. The next is about the blood supply to the lateral wall. The first one will be the arterial supply. For the arterial supply, the lateral wall is divided into four quadrants: an antero superior part, antero inferior part, postero superior part, and postero inferior part. Now the antero superior part is supplied by anterior ethmoidal and posterior ethmoidal artery. They are the branches from the ophthalmic artery. Antero inferior part is supplied by facial artery and the greater palatine artery. Then postero superior part is supplied by sphenopalatine artery. Postero inferior part is supplied by the greater palatine artery. The sphenopalatine and the greater palatine artery, they are the branches from the maxillary artery. Next is about the venous drainage. Anterior part is drained into the facial vein. Posterior part is drained into the pharyngeal plexus of vein. Middle part of the lateral wall is drained into the pterygoid plexus of veins. Next is about the nerve supply of the lateral wall. For the lateral wall, the nerve supply is both special as well as general sensation. The special sensation here is olfaction, that is taken by the olfactory nerves from the olfactory epithelium. The olfactory epithelium lines the upper part of the nasal cavity just below to the cribriform plate of the ethmoid bone. The next is about the general sensation. General sensation is taken by the branches from the three divisions of the trigeminal nerve. For the nerve supply, we are dividing again the lateral wall into four quadrants: antero superior part, antero inferior part, postero superior part, and postero inferior part. The antero superior part, the general sensation is taken by the anterior ethmoidal nerve, which is a branch from the ophthalmic division of the trigeminal nerve. Antero inferior part is taken by the anterior superior alveolar nerve, a branch from maxillary nerve. Postero superior part is taken by the posterior superior lateral nasal branch from the pterygopalatine ganglion. And postero inferior part is supplied by the greater palatine nerve, which is again a branch from the pterygopalatine ganglion. Next is about the lymphatic drainage of the lateral wall. Anterior half of the lateral wall, it passes to the submandibular lymph node. Posterior half drains into the retropharyngeal and the upper deep cervical lymph nodes. Then the next is about the applied anatomy. The hypertrophy of the mucous membrane over the inferior nasal concha, which is a common feature of allergic rhinitis, that is characterized by sneezing, nasal blockage, and excessive watery discharge from the nose. That's all about the lateral wall. And thank you.